Listen, Sara, I do want to ask you that. Did it make you uncomfortable when he said this is Clinton's revenge? This is people who were upset about the 2016 election. Those are things we don't hear from people who are trying to sit on the Supreme Court.
Look, I think the circumstances around this nomination and where we find ourselves, and when there is a person who is alleging 8 or 9 gang rapes that the nominee has participated in, including
that actually was not
women.
The allegation.
Well,
let's put that aside. I want to focus on Dr. Ford and the allegation that was in front of Congress yesterday, and the allegation that we are all focused on. I don't want to take away from it from the other allegations that have come out. Let's focus on the one that people are deciding to have a hearing for, and which the FBI is now investigating along with the others. Focusing on that, and that's what he was defending himself for yesterday. He did bring out very political talking points. Are you comfortable with that, Sara? Would you have been comfortable with that if somebody nominated by President Obama or a Democrat had done the same thing towards the right?
Well, in the context of this environment, which, yes, you're right, he was before the Senate for one specific allegation, but the news environment, of course, was covering everything, and that's the context in which he was sitting there. I'm not uncomfortable. I'm not uncomfortable because at a moment in time when he's defending his honor and his very good character, which he's built up over his career and in hundreds of women who've worked with him, worked for him, been taught by him, attest to his good nature, his mild-mannered, myself included, he's a good, good guy. I don't think in a moment of anger like that, I don't hold him to account for that, for his lifetime of service, where he's been measured, including his years in the district court.
He just didn't have to go there, Sara.
It's also the truth.
Look, what happened. Wait a minute.
It is what has happened in this process.
Can I just make a point here? He was constantly yesterday not just dodging questions, but saying things that were factually untrue. This raises
What did he say that was factually untrue?
Oh, my God. Where do we begin? I mean, just start with, like, a lot of them were small, but they were still important. Take the Renate, you know, the woman in his class, where he tried to say that all of the references of he and 14 classmates to this woman being easy sexually was because they liked her as a friend. That is,
but you're
just
making
complete
a big
bull.
Assumption
that was
about
complete bull. And there were many such
you
moments,
don't know
Sara,
that.
And it really
you
hurt his credibility
that.
With
you
the
do
American
not know
people.
That.
Let me move on.
I actually thought I loved his opening statement. I thought it was completely called for, given what has occurred and given the way the Democrats on the Senate Judiciary handled this. And in my mind, you know, what he said, it is search and destroy. That is what we've seen. That is what Republicans believe. That is what Lindsey Graham very articulately outlined. And, you know, so Judge Kavanaugh,
I
think,
wonder,
had a right
that,
to say
that sort of talk, you know, you talk about and with all due respect here, but that sort of talk, I think, is a sort of talk that only further divides the country.
Katie, give me a break.
I'm serious.
The Democrats are talking about him. They're calling him a rapist. Come on.
This isn't that hard. I mean,
this doesn't work.
Hold on.
I want to work both ways.
Sara, hold on a second. Let's bring in one of the Democrats that you're talking about, Democratic member of the Senate Judiciary Committee, Senator Richard Blumenthal.